Hey chess friends, hope you are doing well. Today I am very excited to share a game where I played against Rifkad, an amazing chess engine. He is a top chess engine and a formidable player, and in this game, he tactically trapped my queen on the board, which will indicate his strategic brilliance and geniusity. So let's get started without wasting any time. I started the game with e4 and we have g6, bishop g7, the modern defense approach which I showcase in many variations in my videos, after knight c3, d6, and a6, followed by bishop d7, where black wants to strike in the center by playing e5, so after castling, playing c6 and b5 is a good choice to consider, or a move like h6, but he decided to go with e6. This is called the small center defense, which many chess streamers like Samurai Hikaru dare to consider in their speedrun queen sacrificing village games. So after bishop g5, queen d2 to make a queen bishop battery to launch a heavy attack on the h6 square, we have castling and a4. You can see that I am protecting the b5 square to advance the pawns because the king side is locked down. After b6, rook e1 and bishop b7 to control the center squares, we follow up with some moves, and I go with h4. This h4 move is masterful to attack on the king side. Rook check tries to protect the queen, and playing e5 or d5 is vulnerable because d5 will lose the pawn on c7 after I exchange the pawns on d5, and playing e5 will create an open file for my queen and rook. So after knight f6 to dominate the center squares, we have e5, kicking out the knight right away because capturing the pawn will lead to a knight attack, as the knight has no good retreating squares. So as the knight reaches h5 to attack the bishop moves back, and h4 threatens to eliminate the knight. The knight has no square to go to, even if it captures the pawn on e5, I will recapture, and you can see that rook d8 might occur, but after captures and exchanges on d8, g4 will come, trapping the knight. Going back to the position, noticing that b4 is vulnerable, black decided to go with rook d8 to control the diagonal. After g4 occurs, since the knight has no retreating square, he decided to capture the pawn on e5, but capturing it back would result in a queen loss for me, so after captures and recaptures, the good thing for black is that he gets the open g-file for his invasion. Playing king f1 is a very bad choice because black can respond with pawn takes d4, attacking the knight. As the knight reaches a2, black can lock down the position by playing c5, giving him a completely good position. Despite being down a knight, he holds the pawn chain, and the knight can arrive at g6, giving him significant advantages. So returning to the position, I decided to go with knight takes e5. I have no fear of the g-file, do whatever you want, rook g8 doesn't matter. Playing bishop g3 is a bad choice because bishop takes e5 can come, pinning the pawn to the queen and creating a deficiency in your position. So, let me share a beautiful quote in Sudden with you. If I cannot do great things, I can do small things in a great way. So in this position, I decided to go with king f1 to save from the rook attack. Can you guess what black considered in this position? Try to pause the video and figure out the move. The move, which is astonishing, is bishop takes g2 check, sacrificing the bishop right away to expose the white king. Rifkad played bishop takes h6, attacking the queen and king simultaneously on the board. What an incredible and brilliant move by Rifkad. He attacks my queen and king. I think this is the first chess engine to make such a beautiful tactical move against me. Good job, Rifkad. He wins the queen, but I still have potential attacks to safeguard my position. He tried to kick out my knight with f6, but as the knight reaches f3, we have queen g6, and queen g2 would be a positional defect, so we discovered that playing knight f3 would be a bad choice, which is why I decided to go with knight e4, sacrificing the knight because bishop takes e5 comes on the board. You should go with rook g7, and my knight reaches g5, creating significant damage and weaknesses in your position. As the queen reaches g6, I am showing you the variation, then I can go with bishop d3. Attacking the queen, yes, you can block it with the knight on f5, but I can play bishop takes g7, if your queen captures it, then knight takes e6 will win your rook. If your king captures on g7, then knight takes e6 will fork your king and rook, supported by my rook. This would be an advantageous position for me. So going back to the position, we discovered that queen g6 is a bad choice, which is why we have rook d6. He has no fear of losing the rook because the other rook is just hanging. After some sequences of moves, we have c3 to create a pawn chain and structure the pieces. It is two rooks versus the queen and the knight for the rook. After h6 and some moves later, it creates a heavy attack on the pawn on h5, and the pawn on e6 can be attacked by my double rooks on e3, so, after some sequences of moves, we have queen f4 and queen h4. You can see that black has many weaknesses on e6. After a couple of moves, we have piece exchanges on the f5 square, and then you can see that we are attacking on the queen side. My double rooks have a very good position on f5, and black is attacking the pawn on b4, but it cannot be captured because the king's position will be in terrible condition. So after rook b7, and after some sequences of moves, we have a king check, and I brilliantly join forces with my rooks on e5. You can see that my knight, along with the rook, is attacking the pawn on h5. After some moves, we have king g5 and queen g2. Then, after some more moves, we have some piece exchanges, and rook h4 is followed by knight f5, threatening to consider rook h6 check, which will lead to checkmate. This is why you have to capture my knight. After that, rook g4 check comes on the board, and at the end of the game, you can see that I have many pawns. This was a very competitive win for me. I defeated Rofkad in the middle game, and by promoting to a new queen, I checkmated him, so it was a very beautiful game. I hope you enjoyed it very much. If so, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Wishing you all the best, bye bye, see you.